have been on the journey with us over the last two-ish years almost. This has been a secret that's been kind of exciting to be able to keep over the last year. And the ability to create massive financial resources, the ability to create incomes, the ability to grow teams exponentially expands. You've kind of heard whispers in the background and you've kind of known that something bigger was coming.
It's more powerful to be unified than it is to be perfect.
A lot of times we talk about building a business from our phones. But we're about to take that to the next level. Guys, it's been almost 2 years in development. Let's take this thing to the next level.
So the back office primarily, we made everything about the why. So everybody has had to have both an Ian username, they've had to have a Livefire username, they've had to have WordPress usernames and all this kind of stuff. We've eliminated all of that.
It was a breezy spring evening in San Diego on April 8, 2007. A parade of sports cars, town cars, and taxis pulled up to a Spanish-style La Jolla beach house on Coast Boulevard. One by one, the cars discharged their casually dressed passengers. These 12 men were the top internet marketing gurus in the world. Between them, they held sway over 30 million email addresses of hopeful online entrepreneurs. These internet marketing gurus had come together for a meeting that was as rare as it was secretive. On the meeting agenda was a single item: how to jointly control and monopolize the entire marketplace of people looking to make a go of it online. A long, blonde-haired man with a surfer dude look was playing host for this meeting at his private La Jolla beach house. We'll call him Mr. K to protect the innocent. Mr. K's beach house was perched precariously on the cliffs of the Pacific coast. The ocean waves hissed in the background. This self-appointed godfather of the guru syndicate greeted each of the men as they entered. He was a bit anxious, but utterly confident about the plan he and a few other internet marketing gurus had hatched to extract every dollar possible from that hopeful list of 30 million people. Now, you're probably wondering who I am and why I'm telling you about this meeting at Mr. K's beach house way back in April of 2007. I'll explain exactly how this all ties together in just a bit. My name's Casey. I'm the lead developer for Empower Network. And at the moment, I'm in kind of a jam. See, I'm locked in a dark room inside a building somewhere in South Florida. And there's only one way I figure I'll ever see the light of day again. I need to use the one-touch blogging platform I built for the Daves. They're on a mission to put an end to the guru syndicate and set things right for aspiring online entrepreneurs. And that's what has the syndicate so worried. They want to stop the 2 Daves from releasing the platform to the world this week. Officially, the platform's working title is the ENV2 blog platform, but the 2 Daves call it the Blog Beast.
Hello?
Hey boss, you get a chance to look at the video I sent you a link to?
I'm watching it right now. Looks like the boys over at Empower Network are fixing to hand over the keys to the kingdom to every average Joe interested in building a business online.
Yeah, I'm sitting here right now looking at some of the latest business blogging statistics, and this is pretty scary. Inside View says that B2B marketers who use blogs generate 67% more leads than the ones that don't. Boss, that's a lot of leads. And these power boys have gone and made the whole blogging experience mobile so anyone can do it without having to be chained to a laptop or desktop.
Cousin, I know that. And on top of that, once someone actually writes 20 to 50 blog posts, their traffic increases by up to 30%. And 30% more traffic is precisely why we cannot let the Empower Boys hand over this kind of easy-to-use tool to the masses. Get Kyle and Honig on it.
All over it, boss. I'll get the cousins on it.
Thanks, cousin. That's pretty, pretty, pretty good.
Hey guys, what's going on? Dave Sharp here, and right now I'm actually here with somebody who's a best friend and a business partner inside of my life and my business. This is somebody that I met on the internet just a few years back, just like you're meeting us right now, Mr. Dave Wood.
Hey folks.
Guys, today in this free training video, I'm gonna tell you the story of how I used a simple blog and some basic marketing to get out of a really bad situation and to create an incredible life for myself, a life where I go wherever I want. I spend time doing the things that I enjoy doing with the people that I love doing them with. In fact, I'm actually going to show you the exact steps that I took. Look, 5 years ago, I was actually homeless. I was just coming off of a 10-year run of being addicted to drugs, alcohol, addicted to really making stupid decisions. And then I discovered a way out. And that's what I want to share with you today.
Dave.
What up, bro?
I got an idea. I think people already know the story of how he went from homeless, broke, and living on the streets to making millions and millions and millions of dollars on the internet blogging. But how about we do something completely different today?
Like what, bro?
Well, how about if instead of us telling these folks what they should do to expand their cash flow online, we tell them what not to do if they want to bring in ridiculous amounts of money from blogging?
You mean like get right down to the meat and the potatoes of what they should actually avoid if they want to make a lot of money and build a real business online?
Exactly. And since blogging has been such a huge part of how we build our businesses, how about if we tell them about the mistakes to avoid? We can call them, for example, the 17 super dumbass blogging blunders that nobody should ever make.
Cut!
Guys, is there any way we could come up with a friendlier name than the 17 super dumbass blogging blunders?
Yeah, you think that's a little bit too offensive?
Dave, what I think he's trying to say is that this launch is going to be seen by a lot of people, and well, you know.
Yeah, probably a little bit offensive. You know, what if we called it
the 17 super dumbass things He-Man would never do with his blog?
Fabulous secret powers were revealed to me the day I held aloft my magic sword and said, "By the power of the blog beast, make me a beast!" I became He-Man Rashton, the most powerful man on the internet. Only two other people share this secret, my friends Dave Wood and Dave Sharp. Together, we protect the internet from the forces of the evil Guru Syndicate.
I like it.
Guys, this is what we do. We teach people how to make money online, being authentic, transparent, and with no BS.
Yeah, and what we're going to do is take the 17 dumbass blogging blunders and divide them into four main categories. Number one, we got the technical blogging blunders. Number two, we got the visual blunders. Number three, we got the content blunders.
And worst of all, number four, the marketing blunders. And these are the ones that are really costing people the most money.
I get it. I'm not here to cramp you guys' style or anything. It's mainly, I was just...
Great, let's do it. Casey! Dave, you haven't used a phone in years. Let me do this.
Hello?
Hey, Casey, what's up, buddy? You got a sec?
Sure, I was just having a cup of joe and making some updates to the BlogBeast platform. What's up?
Can you do me a favor and send over the link to the video that we shot the other day? You know, the one where we walked some of our students through the 17 blogging blunders?
Sure, you got it. Should be in your inbox in about 30 seconds.
Thanks, appreciate you, brother.
No problem.
So, what is it that you do again?
Oh, yeah, like I was saying, I'm the lead developer for a company called Empower Network.
Wow, that sounds pretty important.
I guess so. You know, it's pretty cool. Me and my team have been working for over a year on a totally one-of-a-kind business blogging platform. Pretty sweet, pretty proud of it, but, you know, ultimately, the whole thing is designed to be able to help anyone make money easily online. Yeah, you want to take a look?
Yeah, sure.
There are 17 blunders BlogBeast do not make. If you make these blunders, lights out!
What we're going to do is we're going to actually get into the blogging blunders. And more than anything, instead of just telling you about them, we're going to show you guys watching this video, exactly what people are doing wrong with their blogs, which I think is going to be the real value of this, because when you're seeing this, and as we're going through these blogs critiquing them, you're actually going to be able to identify the things that you're doing wrong as we're going through and pointing some of these things out in other blogs. Do you remember when we we did an event, and this was 2 years ago. Do you remember that lady? And I'm not gonna call her out by name, but she knows who she is, who said that she had taken 2 years to try to get her blog even live.
After I finally got my stuff up, right, which didn't take me 2 years because I was all day and night, maybe she's only part-time, right? Yeah. I don't know. After I got my site up, I then had to fill it with content, then I had to learn how to put sales stuff up, then I had to learn how to embed sales psychology up,
right.
And there were so many technical steps involved in every stage of the process that I wasted hundreds of hours in my first few months on the internet, and it cost me way more money than it should have cost. If you're watching this video and you've been online for longer than a month, you just had your heart pumping when I was talking about that because you know what the hell I'm talking about. Yeah. You've tried to set something up and don't know how. You might be one of these, you know, weirdo programmers, something like that. It's like, I could do that in 5 minutes. You know, I know PHP code. Well, maybe you do. And the truth is you're not making any money because you're missing the other half of the puzzle, which is marketing. Now, Dave Sharp is one of the foremost experts in the world in direct response marketing. In fact, together with the blogging and the culture stuff that I know, and the sales psychology and the influence stuff, Dave Sharp knows we have one of the largest sites on the internet. We actually have a site right now, obviously, that's in the top 200 sites online. Mm. And so you're watching this, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you what people are doing wrong in their businesses. Now, I'm gonna warn you in advance as we're walking through these things. We're gonna show you stuff that if you do on your own, it's gonna take you forever and a ton of money to be able to solve these problems that we're about to point out. However, we're gonna actually come back in one of the videos here in a couple of days, and we're gonna show you how to solve them like that for nothing.
I wanna just point this out, is that I've seen you and I've seen people pay you thousands and thousands of dollars just to go and look at their site. So this is really something of value to not only you guys who are watching the video, but also to the person whose site we're critiquing.
And let's start with this one here. So right now, what's your biggest roadblock and what's holding you back from hitting that?
We've had some traffic already coming in and it's growing. But there's no engagement.
And when you say you're not getting engagement, you mean nobody's commenting on your stuff? Or
right.
What do you mean?
No comments, no likes.
So your problem then is syndicating and getting engagement on the content that you're creating, and that's the biggest thing that you think that your problem is.
Yeah.
When you guys were setting up your website, I know you removed all the content from the site, but we wanted to use this as an example because this is kind of what you started with on the internet. What was the purpose of this website that you created right here?
I'm really into personal development and mindset training, so I just wanted to basically add value and eventually, and I'm working on it now, develop my own mindset product.
You wanted to create...
eventually be able to sell that.
Right, so you wanted to be able to create and sell a mindset product.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what I've really seen with a lot of people that I've coached and consulted with and worked with on my teams and outside of my teams up until this point is really they've spent a whole lot of time setting stuff up. They've spent a whole lot of time, you know, thinking about what they're going to do when they get ready to do it. Right, and they've spent a whole lot of time doing a whole lot of stuff that doesn't make them any money at all. You guys need to get into a situation to where you can start literally just creating content fast. That's number one, because you guys are really likable. I mean, seriously, people want to hear what you have to say. You want to speak. You want to get out there and share your message. But the problem is when you're spending all of your time like buying random stuff that you don't need and setting up random stuff that you don't need to set up, you're not doing what is really your highest paid skill. And I can promise you that you too, setting up domains and setting up your blog, is not your highest paid skill. I was asking you here before we got started, you know, a lot of times I think we go the free route, right? And oftentimes going free costs us a whole lot of money in the long run. So just give me your perspective real quick, and it doesn't have to be long, of the value that you've got really at the end of the day from setting up a bunch of like free sites. You've paid for hosting, but the site, you went and you spent the time yourself setting up the site, going with like one of these free services. At the end of the road, did that actually really pay off?
Really, it hasn't really paid off. I mean, I've definitely more has come out of my pocket than, especially with time.
If you had what we're going to show you here in a second, 10 years ago, I actually think you guys might be traveling the world right now, speaking and making $30,000 a month. Is that cool?
At minimum.
All right, cool.
So you're here because you want to get some feedback on your business from us and on what we can do to help you, and I'm going to help you out with your sites. I want to ask you some questions, though, because I know that you've struggled with some of the things people have struggled with. You've been online for 6 years, okay? When you got started online, how long did it take you to set up your first website, just honestly?
Yeah, so I spent, countless hours trying to figure it out.
So you spent a lot of money, a lot of time. How much money did you spend in your first 6 months?
I would say about $20,000.
In six months?
Yeah.
So tell me real quick, we've got one of your sites up here. What can I do for you today? What are you struggling with in your business that I can help you solve?
So my struggle today is to really have people that come in really have the vision that it is possible, mm-hmm. that they don't know anything, and then they can make money if they take it step by step by step.
And you want to make sure that when your team gets started, just so I'm clear, when you get them started in a business that they believe that they can get set up quickly and get going fast.
Absolutely.
But the fact is you did not get set up quickly, you did not get going fast because it took you 6 months and $20,000 to get going on the internet.
More importantly though, if you could help your team get set up faster, right, to where they're marketing quicker, to where when they look at what they have to do, it just not only looks simpler, but it is simpler. But truthfully, it's not that you're not or somebody out there is not a hard worker. It's more that maybe truthfully they just can't do what we do, right? Maybe they've got a full-time job. Maybe they've got kids. They get home. They've got to go to soccer practice. It's cool that you could have something that easy and that simple for yourself. But what if you could have something that easy and that simple for your team?
I actually think that would be even more important because in the end, it's how many people you can help. To the degree that you do that, you're actually, you know, having success, mm-hmm. right? So for me, that would be, you know, a dream come true, if
right. you would. Now, you've been online since when?
December.
December. So this is your first time, you didn't get online years ago and then start again in December?
No. December was my first time getting online. Yeah.
Okay, what's the one thing that if I could help you with that one thing, it would solve your problem and you'd be able to make money a lot faster?
Ranking on the search engines.
First of all, I just want to redirect your focus. If you're going to rank on the search engines, the purpose is, right, to make sales. Now, the second thing is what's your problem right now with ranking on the search engines? Are you having a hard time building backlinks, taking too time? What's the deal?
For some reason, they're not ranking.
People who are ranking really easily and a lot today are ranking from social interaction and from real conversations and engagements on the posts that they've got. Mm-hmm. Today, people have got to be actually engaging with the information that you're putting out, right? Mm-hmm. Now, we developed something we're going to share with you guys in the next video, where we have a social mechanism for creating massive amount of real backlinks from other people's websites that can get you ranked like that. So we'll actually show you that in another video. I just wanted to redirect your focus that your actual goal is not to rank in the search engines, your goal is to make sales. And that's what we can help you do. So back over to Dave.
No, I do, you know, it's true. When I'm looking at this blog, which is, I believe, the first blog that you ever set up online, right?
Yeah, that's my first blog.
What's going to create sales is by creating content and providing value to people and then them engaging and being attracted to your content, right? But if nobody ever sees the content, then it's kind of hard for them to get engaged with it, right?
Right.
One of the reasons why they don't see the content is because, and this is a two-part thing, they don't see the content and it's not ranking in the search engines, is because there's no viral architecture in the blog. So what I would say, right, from my perspective is, number one, you have two goals. And this is initially, we've now, you know, realized that just selling more stuff is ultimately what you need to do. Mm-hmm. But in order to rank on the search engine, if you rank on the search engines, people will find your stuff. But if I said, hey, right here, right now, I've got a solution that would be set up for you faster than a Facebook profile, right? And we all know that pretty much everybody's got a Facebook profile, yeah. and they're set up really quick. If it was not only had everything in it that you needed to be able to make money, rank in the search engine, and start generating sales, it was also set up not in a day or two, but in an hour or two, would you pay right here, right now, $1 for it?
Yeah.
Cool. And you've been online for 3 months, and so tell me about the struggles that you've been having in your business since you've been online.
Wow. I mean, to figure something out, it's like sometimes it becomes so difficult mm-hmm. to move something from one side to the other, to do a squeeze page that I just learned what it is. It's like, okay, now what do I do?
Basically, so many questions. You make a goal uh-huh. of tomorrow we're going to do a banner. Okay.
Uh-huh.
So tomorrow comes, you start doing a banner, and you end up doing the whole week a stupid banner.
Okay, I got it. So you've been spending the last 3 months then setting up.
Exactly.
Trying to set up.
And how much money have you spent setting up?
Well, setting up to right now, about $1,500.
About $1,500, and that's just setting up. And 3 months, and you're not done yet.
No, it's far from done.
And you're still setting up.
Yes.
I actually clicked on a link on your site, and it went to a page that said, if you want to keep setting up your site, click here, which I actually thought was kind of hilarious.
I've been there for about a week or so, actually, to get that page going, and not yet.
Now, here's the problem that I see what you guys are doing right now is, first of all, this is taking you 3 months, and you're just not finished yet,
exactly.
Right? Now, when somebody puts their email into this form on the side here, what do they go to? Anything, or is this just not set up
they
yet?
They are supposed to go to a free video that I'm going to... Shoot.
So I've been in the same situation that you're in,
okay.
Right? What you really need to do is you need to start making sales, right?
Exactly.
And why you're not making sales is because you're focused on this, right? So what I want to do for you is, first of all, teach you, of course, we're going to teach everybody here over the next couple of videos how to remove all of this resistance. This is the problem of the internet. This is the problem that people have in making money is cognitive resistance and social resistance to just taking massive action. Number one, you've got a capture form, and that's good. We can do a little bit of tweaking and finagling with that to make it actually convert more leads, more sales. But you need to have a way to capture leads, right? Something to sell, and you need to have upsells on the back end. Right? Then you need to bring in enough leads to create enough sales. That's all that you do to make money.
You didn't quit doing what you were doing before so you could be a programmer.
Exactly.
A lot of times we get stuck in things that have nothing to do with making money. If we were to set this up for you in fast track, all of the setup, all of the technical jargon that you're struggling with, and so you can start getting that really awesome personality that people want to connect with and buy from, because you guys are awesome just sitting here hanging out with you. Would that be worth today if it could be set up in the next 24 hours? Dollars.
Ready. Set up.
It's done.
Well, we get two.
You get two of them.
We get two. One for her, one for me.
I want to ask you, actually, because I know that you've had websites for a long time. We're actually looking at one right now. You said you've had this for how many years?
I think 5 years.
5 years, so you've been on the internet actually for a long time. What kind of business is this for?
For a print brochure.
For a print brochure.
I sell advertising for a print brochure for Key West, and then I put all of my clients on my website.
And your clients are for what business?
The big hotels and restaurants and attractions in Key West.
And how long did this website here take for you to get set up when you got started on the internet?
Probably about 3 weeks to a month, maybe.
Okay, and right now you have a goal of making money on the internet.
You know, if I can make some money doing something that I love to do, because I already love this.
Mm-hmm. So my question for you, Amber, is what can I help you with that if you solved right now, it would just remove all the resistance that you've currently got?
I would like to be able to do a video and then upload it right to my Empower blog and then be able to post right from there onto Facebook.
What is the process that you have to go through right now to be able to do something like that? Because obviously you've got a site, and up until now, you've outsourced pretty much everything. You spent, did you say several thousand or?
A couple thousand
to get this site set up. There's a lot of pages. There's a lot that you've done on this site, but what you want is more efficiency. So what is your biggest struggle with the way that you're marketing right now? Just, is it efficiency?
Yeah, mobile.
You want to be more mobile. Mm-hmm. You want to be able to just like I said, create a piece of content
exactly.
And just get it up and then move on with your day. I've been wanting to, as long as I've been in this business, I wanted to work more from my phone too. I want to be mobile. You know, I want to be able to just shoot a video and just upload it right away too. I mean, truthfully, that's what I want.
This does not fit in my purse.
It doesn't fit in your purse. It doesn't fit in my purse either.
Right?
Yeah.
Your man.
So
what actually does fit in my purse.
It fits in his merch.
You need a larger purse.
Yeah, yeah. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you, and we're gonna show you a platform and a solution, really, that we've created that will allow you to be able to do exactly what you want to do and not do it in 3 weeks or 4 weeks, not do it for $996.50, but do it for really honestly an absolute steal and do it right here, right now. Cool?
Absolutely.
She just gave me her credit card.
Sign me up, brother.
Hey Dave.
run that.
Oh, here. I brought one for each of you.
So sorry, Steph. I got caught up making some last minute changes to the mobile upload feature for Blogbeast. I just totally lost track of time.
I understand, honey. It's just that I made you stuffed mushrooms and ginger chicken for dinner, and I thought we could watch a movie together on Netflix like we talked about.
I totally spaced it. I promise I'll try to make it up to you, Beach. As soon as this launch is over, and we make sure that everybody's happy and everybody's taken care of on the new platform, we'll totally take that vacation to Hawaii that we've been talking about.
I know you work hard because you just want to help people have a better life. Drive home safely, okay? I'll see you in a bit, and I'll warm up dinner for you.
Yeah, I'll be home soon. Love you. Bye. Hey, man, sorry. Thanks.
No problem, Casey.
Yeah, accidents happen.
Yeah, they sure do, and we wouldn't want any accidents happening to you or your pretty wife, would we? What's her name again, Hunter?
Her name's Stephanie, but you call her Peach, don't you, Casey?
Peach? That's sweet.
Peach Cobbler Pie.
I'm gonna keep this short, Casey. You get us the codes to the Blogbeast platform by tomorrow so we can tank the system and make sure it all fails. And if not, we're gonna make sure accidents start happening real quick. Capiche?
Did you just say capiche?
Honik, I'm working here. Seriously, Casey, make sure you get us the codes for that platform. And if you don't get us that by tomorrow, you're gonna wish you did.
I just don't know. It's not like it used to be.
It's really not.
I'm scared.
Yeah, it looks bad.
Oh well.
Can you? It looks tight. Let me try it.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Ah! God dang it, Dave. It's not working right.
No, it's not. Hold on. Let me try mine. Mine's tight.
Hey, let me. I don't know if mine's. The crotch just doesn't feel right, Dave.
Yeah.
It just.
Ow! Shoot! It's just I need to try a little to the right though.
Yeah, little over there.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Shoot.
Got it.
Okay,
got it.
All right, yeah. Yeah. Oh, I'm ready. That's better.
Yeah, much
better. I feel better.
Hey, guys, you're on in 5, okay?
Thanks, Trev. We'll be out in a minute, buddy.
Dude, going through the worst blog ever yesterday was not fun at all.
Well, dude, you did exaggerate the dumb acidness a little.
Well, I wanted to show people how bad a blog could be and how much that stuff really costs them in their business when they don't do this stuff right.
The truth is that these days, people can't really even afford to make one of those blunders, man.
Remember how on one of those test blogs, we just had a couple of those blunders on the page?
Yeah, and how traffic, leads, sales, and engagement dropped like a stone.
And I remember because we intentionally screwed up that page to see what would happen.
Well, dude, we did it for the betterment of bloggers everywhere. You know, you remember what they used to say, just start a blog.
Yeah, just doesn't matter if it's any good at all.
If you build it, they will come.
You know, Dave, that's just not true anymore. And today's gonna be a lot more fun because we just get to dress all sexy like superheroes. The fact is, people just need something that they can do that's easy to do on the internet. They need this stuff done for them so they can just get started in their business and make money.
Yeah, and you know, something that's like not technically complicated.
And I'm happy about that because Casey's just about to walk us through in this next video.
Dude. Where is the old Case Meister? He was actually supposed to shoot me a link to a video he wanted me to take a look at.
Not sure. He'll turn up, though. No one's reliable as good old Casey. He's got...
the power!
Folks, we didn't spring into existence as professional blogging superhero millionaires. We started out just like you, one step at a time.
Guys, here's what you need to do next. First, review this video and review it a couple of times. Then download the full list and explanation of the 17 super dumbass blogging blunders that we made for you guys. So now, you could have a list of the blunders that you absolutely positively don't want to make with your blog. Just click on the button below and help us spread the love, baby, and the information in this video by sharing it with your friends and family all over your social media sites like Facebook and Twitter. And when you share it, you'll get a download link to the 17 super dumbass blogging blunders. So don't be a wussy. Be a blog beast. Ooh, I like that. A blog beast. Speaking in the next video, Dave and I, we thought it'd be cool for you to see how easy it can be to set up and run a good blog. So with the help of our lead developer, Casey, we'll show you the exact opposite of the worst blog ever created.
A beast blog.
Right, we wanted you to see how easily a blog can actually be created. I'm talking about a blog that gets more audience engagement, more social media sharing, and more brand awareness, and most importantly, more traffic and more sales conversion. Stack all of that together, and the result is obviously more business and more money for you.
Folks, what you're gonna see in this next video is some of the strongest training ever created. Dave and I have tested millions of dollars worth of traffic against these concepts, so seriously, don't miss it.
Guys, thanks for watching this video.
Yeah, this has been a ton of fun. We hope you learned something that you're gonna put to good use.
Cool, we'll see you guys in the next video.
See you later.
Hey, guys.
What?
Listen, I'm really sorry to interrupt your shoot, but I've got some disturbing news.
Show us what's going on.
You need to see this post on Casey's BlogBee site. This is a video he just left.
Hey, Dave and Dave and Power Network, I think I'm about to be kidnapped. You got to keep the launch going and cannot involve the police at all, or I may not make it out of this alive. I've already checked and made sure my wife is okay. Told her to lay low for a while. I'll be in touch.
What the hell? Who would kidnap Casey, dude? You gotta be shitting my pants.
Trav, would you shit in his pants?
I wouldn't even shit in my own pants.
Dude, why wouldn't you shit in my pants?
Guys, that's not the point. What Casey's saying here on this video is that we can't even call the cops or else he's not gonna get out alive. There's
only... gotta keep the launch going, too.
Dude, there's one thing to do. Get Casey ourselves!
So, now you see how things tie together. The Guru Syndicate doesn't want the Dave's launching the BlogBeast platform this week. It's a system that anyone can use to actually make money and build their business online. And that will cut into the syndicate's business selling things that just don't really work. So now I'm trapped in a warehouse somewhere in South Florida, which really isn't any fun at all. But I've got a few tricks up my sleeve. Funny thing is, the Daves talk all the time about how they're not like the gurus, and I never really understood it before. The Daves are about empowering people and helping them succeed. Listen. If you can hear this, that means my messages are actually getting out and ending up on my BlogBeast site. I need your help to get out of this jam so I can help the Daves launch the BlogBeast platform. Right now, especially right now, nothing would make me happier than knocking the Guru Syndicate down a peg, except for maybe getting home to see Stephanie. I love you, Peach. So, if you're listening, keep watching the launch videos and keep checking my BlogBeast posts. Whenever I can, I'll be sending out messages from my smartphone to help the Daves find me. It seems I'm able to send texts, audio, and video to my BlogBeast site, but when I dropped my phone last night, I lost the tracking system and the ability to receive calls and messages. Thank God I built the system to be one-touch simple so anyone can use it. Apparently, even a guy with his hands tied behind his back. Please help the Daves try to figure out where the heck I am. Uh-oh, someone's coming. I better sign off.